At least 8 forest fires are raging in the mountainous areas in the Cordillera Administrative Region. Joining us on Top Story to talk to us about efforts to battle Inferno, we have Acting Municipal Fire Marshal of the Sagada Fire Station, Senior Fire Officer 4, John Dakwag. Fire Marshal, good afternoon, po.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, we would first like to know the situation there. Tuloy pa po ba yung forest fire at kung tuloy po ba, lumalaki pa?
Sa ngayon, sir, hindi kasi continuous yung forest fire dito, sir. Paputol-putol ba ibang lugar.
So po, meron pong nawawala at bigla naman merong magkakaroon pong sunog doon sa area.
Sir.
Yung area pong pinag-uusapan natin, ito yung sa may Mount Santo Tomas, ano? Doon po sa sunog, gano'ng kalaking area po ba ang may sunog?
Ay, sorry sir. Ay, yung Santo Tomas po, sir, ay panang malayo yan sa Sagada, sir.
Ah, doon po sa area nyo, saan po yung sunog na inaapulan nyo?
Super, sir. Wala na, sir. Ay, may katatawag lang kanina na ano, pero under control na, sir.
Fire under control. Saan po yung area na yun na nagkasunog?
Dito, sir, sa may junction ng, ano, sir, sa papunta ng Balili at saka Takong, sir.
Tapos nung kasagsagan po, gano'n po kalaking sunog yun nandun? Gano'n kalaking area?
Wala pang estimate na affected area kasi katatapos lang yung respondi, sir.
Nalaman na po ba natin kung ano po kinumpisa na sunog?
Ay, under investigation pa, sir.
Oh, sige po, Fire Marshal, tawag na lang po kami ulit pag nakakuha na po kayo ng mas maraming detalye. Acting Municipal Fire Marshal of the Sagada Fire Station, SFO4, John Dakwag, maraming salamat po. The legal team of Philippine televangelist Apollo Quibuloy receives a Senate order to testify before a committee hearing in March. A copy of the subpoena seen by ABS-CBN News showed Quibuloy's lawyer received a document on Thursday. He was told to show up on the March 5 hearing of the Senate Committee on Women to answer allegations of sexual abuse against him by former members of his congregation. The controversial religious leader was previously warned of arrest by panel chair Senator Rizo Ontiveros if he ignores the order. A subpoena was also issued for Quibuloy by the House, this time over the possible revocation of the franchise of the Davao-based media outlet SMNI. Similarly, House Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Gonzalez Jr. said Quibuloy might be held in contempt if he fails to show up. Gonzalez also reminds Quibuloy no one is above the law. Congress is deliberating whether to revoke SMNI's license to broadcast over alleged violations of its franchise. Another election watchdog also sounding the alarm over Miru systems. Contradaya says public records show that Miru has been involved in alleged mishandled elections and corruption scandals. The group also called on the COMELEC to work with election watchdogs to ensure the midterm polls will be efficient and clean.
If you want a clean election system, the COMELEC should cooperate with election watchdogs and really try to prove that the election system is transparent from start to finish and that we can put trust in the voters that their votes are being counted clean.
Philippine President Marcos Jr. is still studying the 5% raise in premium contributions of state health insurer PhilHealth. Malacanang issued the clarification after PhilHealth Chief Emmanuel Ledesma said Marcos had no objections to the premium hike implemented last month. In January, Marcos ordered a study on calls to suspend the implementation of the contribution raise. Philippine Health Secretary Ted Erbosa advocated for the hike suspension, saying PhilHealth has enough money to continue providing benefits. The universal health care law mandates the annual increase in PhilHealth contributions starting 2020. But Malacanang has suspended the hike since 2022 due to socioeconomic challenges brought by the COVID pandemic. An economist sees the need to balance the interests of stakeholders in the proposed 100 peso daily pay hike for minimum wage earners recently passed by the Senate. Dr. Alvin Ang says if the intention to raise wages is to cope with the cost of living, he believes the measure will have little effect. Ang also proposes further study on the effects of the wage hike bill, including who can take on the additional cost. He adds government assistance should be extended to businesses that may struggle with the pay bump.
Kailangan siguro magkaroon ng unified na pag-aaral. Tignan natin saan ba talaga kaya yan at saan ba hindi kaya. Hindi mo makokontrol ang presyo ng bilihin. At katulad din ng sweldo, sana, ganun din sana ang tingin natin, eh hindi natin maikokontrol yan. Kasi kapag kinontrol natin yan, eh talagang may winners and losers. So baka, kung mas targeted, sino ba talaga nahihirapan, bigyan mo ng ayuda.